Hi guys, Mark here, and as part of a series for beginning photographers, I decided to explain aperture. Aperture is critical to understand because it ties directly to the relationship between it and shutter speed and ISO, which are the three key factors in using your camera, especially in manual mode. At its basic form, aperture is the opening and closing of the blades inside of the lens. It's one of the factors that determines how much light gets to your camera's sensor. Here's an example. Let's say you're somewhere dark, like at a concert where you can't use any flash and you want to take photos. You need to know how to control aperture so you can get enough light on the sensor to get a properly exposed photo. Even then, you'll want to understand ISO, because if you still don't have enough light at f4 or even 2.8 or need more depth of field, you have to increase your ISO, maybe from 200 to as high as 1600 or 3200, but that's another video. As you can tell, ISO, shutter speed, and aperture directly affect each other when creating photos. And in this video, I'll try to explain f-stops, which is the aperture size, and the relationship to what effect it has on your lens's ability to let more or less light into your sensor. Now, the larger the f-stop number is, the smaller the opening is, letting in less light. At f2.8, the blades open to larger size. At f22, they close down very small. I know what you're thinking, this seems backwards. It does, and this was very confusing to me and everyone else when they were learning photography, because it's opposite of what you'd think. Here's how aperture works. Here is the examples of what I'm talking about when it comes to explaining aperture a little bit better for you. This is a chart I put together here, and that shows if you can see f2.8, again, you'd think the larger the number, the bigger the opening. It's backwards, like I said. The f2.8 is actually your largest opening. It's letting the most light in, and f22 is the smallest opening. It's letting the least amount of light in. So, when you're letting the least amount of light in, you have more depth of field. So the farther, the higher your f-stop number, the more depth of field, the more you have in focus in your photo. The smaller the f-stop number, or the larger the f-stop aperture, your depth of field decreases and it allows more light into the sensor, as you can see here. So if we were to, again, example that, imagine that f2.8 is a big opening on your lens and f22 is very, very tiny. And some cameras and bodies, full frame or medium format, depending on what you use, even some lenses even go up to f32. So I mean, it's crazy, and there's even prime lenses that go down to f1.4 or f1.2. So there's lots of ways to look at this. So if we were to go over to the actual dial, and let's take a look at this, to get a good feeling for aperture, try setting your camera mode on AV, or aperture value. This puts you into aperture priority mode. So when you do this, your camera will automatically adjust the ISO and shutter speed for you when you change your aperture with the dial on your camera. So just go out a few hours, put it on AV or A mode, let it override your other settings and handle them automatically, and just see how it works. Hey, there's photographers who make a good living in AV mode, believe me. So don't be afraid to do this. But if you want total control, you'll want to work your way through some other courses here, and so you really understand how to be on full manual mode one day. This is really important, especially when you start using speed lights and studio strobes. You'll have to control everything in manual mode to really understand what you're doing. Now let's take a look at a few images here and get an idea of what's going on. And I'm going to show you, these are just the salt and pepper shakers that I shot. And let me get over to those. And I've got this overlay on so you can see what's going on here. I've got this working its way up from F4 to F22. And I want you to focus, I focused right here on this salt shaker. So as I change my f-stop or aperture, you will see that the shutter speed will change in relation to the f-stop. The ISO is always at 100 on these shots. So let's go ahead and go over to f5.6, and you can watch right here, watch these two numbers. f5.6 is at 1/13, and you can see the depth of field. The pepper shaker is completely blurred in f4, f5.6. The pepper shaker is starting to get a little more focus. f8, a little even more. f11, still more focus. f16, getting close. And f22, you can see how it's really come into focus now. So there's not much difference. And understand, these are only about an inch and a half apart right here. So I'm going to toggle between f4 and watch the pepper shaker. It's f22 now. There's f4. And look how quickly that blurs out. So this plane right here that is parallel to my sensor on my camera is what's causing this to go out of focus with the aperture being at f4. So understand, you can get really creative using the aperture. Just take a look at food or products the next time you're looking through magazines and see how critical aperture can be in producing high-end photos. Many food or product photographers use lenses where they get down to f1.4 or 2.8 so they can focus on just part of the food, for example, a steak, and it's blurred out from about an inch behind the focus point all the way through to the background. In landscape photography, you would want to be around f16 to f22. That way you can get everything clear and in focus. And when you're using AV, you want to use autofocus single point, which is right here. And now this is a single dot, and this would be if you're shooting people, and this will meter for whatever you put that dot on. So if you want to focus on somebody's eye and you want that to be in at good exposure, you'll want to be focused on their eye. You don't want to use the multi-focus, which these are actually off the lens of my camera. This is the single dot. You can see where I was focused on that salt shaker. And then this is the multifocus. This just picks up everything. You don't want to be shooting AV in that unless you're shooting landscapes and big, enormous scenes. You want to be on the single dot focus. Now, a couple of quick tips you can keep in mind is that when photographing people, make sure to focus on the eye that's closest to you, which would be like this one. For landscapes where you normally want everything in focus, you can use multifocus areas, but again, stay around f16 to f22 to help maximize your depth of field and your focus. So hopefully this helps you become a little more familiar with using aperture. Now go out there, experiment, have a little fun. I want to thank you for giving the video a thumbs up and a like, and of course for subscribing. This helps me to keep making future videos, and if you subscribe, you'll know exactly when they come out. So thanks, get out there and shoot. I hope to see you soon.